My topic is related with the biology. It will be a change for you, I guess. I will talk about the influence of climate change on the smallest portion of the our ocean's picoplankton community. And climate change is defined as the changes in the mean state of the climate. And overall, 4.5 billion years of history, climate has been changed many, many times. However, today's condition is different because the main reason of this temperature increase is release of anthropogenic greenhouse gases, in fact. And as you all know, the major greenhouse gases which cause these problems are carbon dioxide, methane dioxide, and the other one. And the phenomena is known as the greenhouse effect. The radiation comes from the sun will normally usually absorb half of it by the clouds, some portion by the vegetation, some portion it by the ocean, and the rest of is some of it absorbed by the ocean and the land, and it heat up the earth, and the small fraction is usually captured by the greenhouse gases. But as we increases the greenhouse gas concentration, we increase the temperature in the atmosphere. So the IPCC concluded that today's global increase is resulting from the anthropogenic facilities with 95% accuracy. And with the industrialization, our greenhouse gas emission has been increased drastically. As a result of this, ocean has been increased, ocean temperature and global temperature has been increased. And why are the impacts of climate change on marine ecosystems so important is that half of the human population is live in oceans, and our well-being is dependent on the nutrient come from oceans, and the works we do for living is in the oceans, and also the oxygen we breathe in is come from the ocean, half of the primary production. And also we are connected with oceans with food chain, and the fundamental of it is photosynthesis, and plankton is the microorganism which responsible for it. In fact, 99% of the global vegetation is terrestrial environment, and they only produce half of the oxygen we breathe in, and the remaining half of it is produced by the phycoplankton. Phycoplankton, the examples could be named as Sinococcus and Pleurococcus. They are smaller microscopic well-beings. Their cell size is between 0.2 micrometers. They have high surface to volume ratio, so their buoyancy in the ocean is high, and they don't sink in the water, so they can reach up to lower nutrient concentrations very easily. However, their greater competitors are nanoplankton. They are usually abundantly found in coastal areas where nutrient concentration is higher. And microplankton is greater, larger size. They usually form chains in order to stay in the sea surface so that they can get nutrients from the ocean. And in this picture, you'll see the coastal area is highly oligotrophic, highly eutrophic, which means they have high nutrient for photosynthesis. And the offshore water is highly oligotrophic, low primary production, so they have low nutrients. And as a result of it, as you can see in the offshore waters, phycoplankton, the smallest fraction, is more dominant, and in the offshore is the opposite is true. So how if climate change impact these microorganisms? In fact, there is two ways. First of all, the sea surface temperature is increases. This impacts the metabolism and their composition. And also carbon dioxide we release in the atmosphere. 1/3 of it is directly absorbed by the ocean. So pH decrease in the ocean, carbon concentration in the ocean is drastically increasing. So as you can see from the picture, climate sea surface in the oceans is increasing. However, this is not dominant case. This picture is representing the climate anomalies, climate increase anomalies in the January in Middle East, Mediterranean Sea. However, as you can see, there is no significant variation. However, in July, the concentration, not concentration, the temperature variation is quite significant. So this seasonal anomalies may cause increase in the abundance time, abundance duration, and the composition of picoplankton. In the figure, you can see the composition of picoplankton in the summertime of Mediterranean Sea. As you can see, heterotrophic bacteria is the most dominant one, and it is followed by cyanobacteria and Prochlorococcus. And in the future, when the temperature increases, Pleurococcus could be much more dominant than Staphylococcus because they are greater in nitrogen uptake capabilities in higher temperatures. And heterotrophic bacteria is quite sensitive to the temperature. As temperature increases, their metabolic actions usually increases. So probably they will become much more dominant in the composition. And also ocean in warming is change the mixed layer depth. What is mixed layer depth? During summertime in the sea surface, during summertime in the sea surface, at the top we have high temperature and low nutrient conditions. Nutrient is lower because the remaining is used for photosynthesis. However, in the below we have low temperature and high nutrient. During winter time, the below part will come up to the surface and support the system and provide nutrients which is necessary for the photosynthesis. However, when the mixed layer depth become more severe, the nutrient inputs will be decreased, which could not be able to support the system as they used to be. The oxygen concentration will be less oxygenated, so nutrient cycles will be decreased. As a result of it, primary production in the oceans and the fish population will decrease. And salinity will also be affected by the temperature change, because every degree of temperature increase, the contrast between the maximum and minimum values of salinity increase by 8%. What means is salinity will become higher in salt areas and become lower in fresher areas. And the second important metabolism is ocean acidification. As carbon dioxide in the ocean increases, the hydrogen ion concentration is increases and pH decreases. This will disturb the equilibrium between inorganic organic system and reduce the concentration of carbonate ions. So as a result of it, the majority of marine calcifiers which require carbonate to produce calcium carbon dioxide will reduced because the carbonate ions available will make it more difficult and they need more effort to catch them. So their diversity and population will be decreased as a result, as the modeling studies and mesocosm experiments showed us. And also in nature, ratio to carbon to nitrogen to phosphorus is constant in both oceans and both the picoplankton. However, we constantly increase the carbon in the oceans, so their stoichiometry may change. And another problem is that as hydrogen concentration increases, the acid-base balance for the homeostasis will changing. So photosynthesis and associated nutrient uptake by individual cells decreases. And nutrient cycles will also be changed. As temperature increases, oxygen will get less oxygen will oceans kept, and the nitrification and nitrogen fixation processes will increase. As a result of it, there could be a shift away from the nitrate and nitrate used microorganisms to reduce nitrogen using species. And also, in addition to other nutrients, phosphate and iron and silica will become much more important in the photosynthesis cycle for completion. And since we increase the carbon dioxide constantly and the limited nitrogen will become limited, probably plankton will become use this excess carbon dioxide for other metabolic activities, which may cause the production of toxins or etc. So species that are best able to grow and complete under altered conditions become ecologically dominant. In phycoplankton case, Cynonychus and Pleurococcus will become much more dominant than larger taxa, and bacterial production, respiration, and biomass will become increased. And also the frequency and duration of harmful algal blooms will increase as a result of climate change. Harmful algal blooms is the increase of one kind of phytoplankton, which is in a way that they deplete the oxygen, block the sunlight, and they may release toxins that are dangerous to animals and humans. In the picture, you can see Alexandrium catenella, which is a usually bloom, they have 60 days. However, with the temperature increase, their bloom time increased due to over almost 200 days. So this will increase their abundance, and this will increase the frequency of bloom times. Also, as the carbon increases in the nitrogen limited conditions, cellular texture, because they use secondary metabolisms, their cellular texture increases, and they may produce more toxic compounds. So thank you for listening. If you have any questions, I will be happy to answer them.